Welcome to Enots Engineering, I'm Alan. In today's video, we're making a test bar to check your tailstock for its vertical and horizontal position to the headstock. I use a piece of silver steel and set it up in my chuck to run true. If you have a 3-jaw self-centering chuck, you don't need to bother too much, as when you're center drilling, the center drill will drill the holes central. So let's go into the workshop, see how we do it. Well, today the temperature in the workshop is about 60 degrees. What I want to do today is check my headstock center height to my tailstock center height in both axes. So first of all, I need to remove the chuck. I just use a steel bar between the chuck jaws. Move it to the position where I can lock my headstock. Lock the spindle and then just tap the bar and the chuck comes undone. Place a piece of wood on the bed to protect it, then unscrew the chuck. First of all, I'll use this to clean the bore. Morse taper on this end and number one on the other. Cleaning this wharf out. Now in this headstock, I'll just put this center Morse taper with the center on the end. That just holds in there. On the tailstock end, let's clean the bore out with the bore cleaner. And put number one Morse taper center in this end. Put the two together. Now a quick way of checking if your centers are in line is just hold a rule in the middle and just bring the centers together. So if your centers are the same height, the rule should be vertical, and if it leans left or right, it means your centers, one's lower than the other. And to the same again, check that way. Your rule should be straight, not going to the left or to the right. But you must have good centers with a good point on them. And that looks okay. Now, if I needed to adjust the center of the tailstock, there are two things you can do. Now on the back of the tailstock there is a mark which shows you your zero position. Now to alter the tailstock backwards and forwards, you can use this grub screw here, and it slides the top of the tailstock backwards or forwards on this tenon there. So to do that, you slacken or tighten up this screw, and there's one on the opposite side, so between the two you can move it away or towards you, and you use that also when you're turning a taper. You can turn a Morse taper by offsetting the tailstock to the degree that you need. But don't forget to take the clamp off, because if you have the clamp on, it holds the tailstock in position. Take the clamp off, adjust the screws. If you want it away from you, slacken this one off, tighten the back one up. If you want it towards you, tighten this one up and slacken the back one off. And then once you have the position, just make sure that they are both tight so it can't move. Now if you need to adjust the tailstock upwards, what you have to do is slacken both screws off, and you can then lift the tailstock off the base, but you'll need to undo the clamp underneath to clear it. And you just put some shim along the base, depending on how high. Now at the moment I have I think it's a 3,000 shim under this tailstock. I've had this lathe for 50 years, so over the 50 years, not only the bed, but the tailstock as well, wearing every time you move it backwards and forwards. And by putting some shim underneath this face, in between the two, lifted it back up, and it's now online. Now I'll just make a simple test bar, show you how to set your tailstock. All I have at the moment is a piece of silver steel, which is this is 10mm silver steel. If you're making a test bar, I would probably use 15 or 20mm silver steel. Put that in your lathe chuck. I've just placed a dial indicator in my tool post. Bring that up to touch the part. Switch that on. Turn around slowly. And you can see there it's running out about half a thou. Each division's a tenth of a thou. Now what I want to do is get that to zero. Now I must point out that this 3-jaw self-centering chuck is a Bernard grip true chuck, and that means I can adjust the chuck to get it running true by altering the screws around the outside. If we get the lowest point, which is there, take the adjuster that's nearer the lowest point, adjust it, try again, adjust the jaws in and out to get the component running true. If you have a standard 3-jaw self-centering chuck, just move on to the machining part. Okay, so that's running at probably less than a tenth of a thou. A tenth of a thou, so that'll be okay. Face it off in the chuck. Turn the bar around in the chuck. Just recheck the run out again on the other end. Then face off and centre drill. Take the bar out the chuck. I now have a small test bar. Put a lever between the jaws. Just tap. Unscrew the chuck. Now if I drop the chuck, at least it's going to hit the block rather than the lathe bed. Clean the centre. Put the centre in there and the centre in the tailstock. clean centre. Centre in. Now set your dial indicator on centre line to the bar. The problem with using a ball end on a diameter, all I want to find out is the distance backwards and forwards. But as I move along, if one end's higher than the other, the ball will go off centre line and below, giving a reading, which could be wrong. So to get a correct reading, I need a flat face on this end. So I'm going to change the end and stylus for a flat one. If this end was higher and you set it to zero with a round ball on the end, if you're on centre line here, as you come down you're going below centre line and the ball would run down giving you a reading, which was an error. Having a flat face, your indicator will run on the outside diameter regardless of the height. Set the dial indicator to zero there, wind it back down. So over that length it's 1 thou, which is quite good, I think. Thou in a... So I'm not going to try and correct that because I can only get worse. I doubt whether I'll get better than that. Now we'll check the top of the bar to check whether there's any wear in the tailstock in the vertical position. On this end I'll set my dial indicator to zero by moving across the top, so I don't need a flat stylus on the end. Zero there, move it down the other end. Down this end, point 0.015 of a millimetre. I think that's about 6/10 of a thou. So that's a simple way of checking the height. Zero it on this end on the height and move down to this end and check the height here. And that will tell you whether your tailstock's lower or higher than your headstock. And the way we did it on the front was take a flat bottom on your dial indicator, zero one end, go to the other end, and that will tell you how far you're out backwards and forwards. So as I'm within a thou or around a thou mark on each one, I'm not going to bother trying to adjust that because I don't think I'm going to get it much better than that. Well, there we are, simple test bar to check your tailstock height, whether it's higher or lower or in or out to your headstock. Oh well, that's it for today. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope it was useful. And we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.